Good morning and welcome to my channel. I have not been uploading to this channel for quite some time, and I think I started it back at around 2012. I got a lot of stuff on here, so you might want to check it out. A lot of interesting stuff, but I haven't been using it at all. But I thought I would give reacting a chance. So today we're gonna do a TV show reaction. And you already know what it is, Star Trek, the original series. And we're going to be doing episode one today, which is The Man Trap. I already did the original pilot, which I guess was unaired and didn't work. And so maybe this was considered the pilot, I don't know. But the original pilot had different people in it. Almost there was, I guess, one or two people that were the same as what will be in this series here. So yeah, the original pilot, The Cage, was pretty good. I enjoyed it, but it got blocked when I put it up. And then I tried to repair it using the copyright YouTube tools, which did repair it and make it public, but it cut out probably half of the video, so the sound of half of the video, so it was completely worthless, so I don't have that anymore. Anyway, so I thought I would try this first episode, The Man Trap, Season 1, Episode 1, The Man Trap. I remember seeing Star Trek as, you know, as a kid. I was 4 or 5, I guess, when it came out originally. And I've seen bits and pieces of it here and there, but I've never actually watched a whole episode. And I don't really know anything about it other than it's a space voyage out into space, which I enjoy. I enjoy the old flying saucer movies from the 50s and 60s. So I don't know if this is going to be like that. This seems to be more colorful and modern than those old black and white. So anyway, we're going to get on to this. I'm going to stop blah, blah, blahing here. And we'll get on to The Man Trap and see what this is going to be all about. I bought the entire DVD, Blu-ray, actually, version of this. So this is going to be off of the Blu-ray things. So anyway, I've got my listening devices. We'll get those installed here. And we'll get started on The Man Trap. So here we go. Looking forward to this and learning all about the Starship Enterprise. I do know that much. Ship is called the Enterprise. Here we go. Let's get started.
Captain's log, stardate 1513.1.
Our position, very nice.
Orbiting planet M113. On board the Enterprise, Mr. Spock, temporarily in command.
I know who Mr. Spock is. He was in
the ruins of an ancient and long dead civilization. Ship Surgeon McCoy and myself are now beaming down to the planet's surface. Our mission,
Surgeon McCoy,
routine medical examination of archaeologist Robert Crater and his wife Nancy.
And I know who
routine,
Captain Kirk is.
For the fact
is.
That Nancy Crater
I
is
recognize
that one
him
woman
right off.
In Dr. McCoy's past.
William Shatner.
Shall we pick some flowers, Doctor? When a man visits an old girlfriend, she usually expects something like that.
Is that how you get girls to like you?
I already forget the name of this planet.
Doesn't seem to be anybody around, does it?
Well, they'll be along. You rushed us down 10 minutes early.
All right, I'm excited to watch these. Try to get a video a week out. And maybe more
Professor?
If I can.
Professor?
A lot of unknowns here. So that's a doctor there in the blue.
Nervous, Dr. McCoy?
Yeah, a little bit, I guess. I see we walked
I
out of each other's
I've
lives 10 years ago. She married Crater, and for all I know, she may have forgotten me completely.
All the bonehead ideas, Jim. How do I let myself in for things like this?
Leonard.
Nancy.
Hello.
Leonard.
It's good to see you.
Let me look at you.
You haven't aged a day. Oh, this is Captain Jim Kirk of the Enterprise.
Jim Kirk? Who's that?
Mrs. Crater? I've heard a great deal about you.
Oh, good, I hope.
He is Admiral seeing Crewman somebody Darnell. Different.
How do you do?
Or older, anyway. Oh, wow. And now he's seeing somebody...
Excuse me, sir, but...
Much
Ma'am,
younger.
If I didn't know better, I would swear that you were somebody I left behind on Wrigley's pleasure planet. It's funny, you're exactly like a girl that...
A little less mouth, Darnell.
I'm sorry, sir. I didn't mean to, I mean, I know it's impossible, of course.
Why don't you step outside, Darnell?
Are they both seeing this for real?
Thank you, sir.
Maybe I'll step outside, too.
What? And let Plum examine me all alone?
Plum?
Plum?
A nickname I gave Leonard when we were very young.
Okay, so apparently that's
I'll wait for
who
the, professor
the doctor
and I'll
is
catch you both at once.
And then the gray-haired
I better
version
go get
is
Bob.
What?
Every time he starts digging,
the captain
he gets
is seeing.
Sleep, food, everything.
And then this guy's seeing somebody completely different.
It's quite warm here, isn't it?
What this all means, I have no idea.
Log. Additional entry. Since our mission was routine, we had beamed down to the planet without suspicion. We were totally unaware that each member of the landing party was seeing a different woman.
Mm-hmm.
A different Nancy Crater.
Professor Crater, I'm Captain Kirk. This is
the Roy Captain and the intrepid doctor cross interstellar space to preserve our health. Oh, your sense of duty is overwhelming. Now, will you please go back where you came from and tell whoever issues your orders to
get
leave me and my wife alone?
Coffee,
we need additional salt against the heat. Aside from that, we're doing very well, thank you.
I'm pleased to hear you're doing well, but I'm required to confirm that fact.
Doubtless, the good surgeon will enjoy prodding and poking us with his arcane machinery. Go away. We don't want you.
This guy is not very
what
happy.
What is unimportant right now? What you will get is what is required by the book.
McCoy. I've heard Nancy speak of a Dr. McCoy.
Well, that's me. Didn't she mention I was here?
You've seen Nancy?
She went out to get you.
Well, you've seen her, too. You were with the good doctor.
Yes, why?
Well, it certainly hasn't aged her. She looks exactly as I knew her 12 years ago. Amazing, Jim. Like a girl of 25.
Oh, sorry. I'm sorry, Captain. Sit down. I seem to have forgotten my manners.
Quite all right. I'm not joking, Jim. She hasn't aged a day. There's not a gray hair in her head.
She's got some gray bones. Excuse me, Professor. She's a handsome woman, yes, but hardly 25.
Yeah, the doctor was seeing her as...
You've seen my wife through the eyes of your past attachment, Doctor. I'm sure when Nancy lets... When you see her again, she'll be of a believable age.
When Nancy lets...
Oh, at any rate, she doesn't look a day over 30.
Genuine affection. I'm glad you still feel it for her.
Sounded like it to me.
Leonard, isn't it? She's a fine woman.
Open your mouth.
Well, I thought the machine was...
The machine is capable of almost anything. I'll still put my trust in a healthy set of tonsils. Now open your mouth.
Uh-oh. Is there any other... Doesn't sound like there's anybody else here, and oh my goodness, it's... Oh! Looks like some form of lipstick, I guess.
Dead, Jim. A strange. Red mottling all over his face.
What happened?
What do you suppose happened, Captain? You beamed down a crewman who doesn't know better than to eat an untested plant.
I've just lost a crewman, Mrs. Crater. I want to know what happened.
Well,
just take it easy, Nancy. Just tell us what you know.
Well, I was just...
A poisonous plant? Well, it looks pretty hot
there. I couldn't find Bob, and I was coming back. I crossed to your crewman. I wanted him to know I wasn't offended by the things he'd said back there. You remember? That I noticed he had a Borgia plant in his hand. Before I could say anything, he'd taken a bite from it. He fell. His face all twisting.
A Borgia plant.
Why did you look at me like you don't believe me?
No. It's not that at all. It's something entirely different.
Is he now seeing her with gray hair like that?
Jim, I suppose we could complete these examinations later.
We don't need an examination. You can see that. Perhaps you'd better take your man and...
We're well aware of our next duty.
It would be really difficult to
complete your examinations tomorrow.
Still have these two guys see her as she really looks. So
transporter room.
Transporter room, Captain.
Lock on her. Three beaming up.
Just showing her with the
salt.
Gray hair.
Did ask him about more salt tablets.
Salt?
I'll take care of the provisioning, Nancy.
I don't need more salt tablets. I don't take salt tablets, but I've cut salt out of my diet because I have high blood pressure now.
Miss Uhura, your last subspace log contained an error in the frequencies column.
Uhura? Is that what he called
her? Sometimes I think if I hear that word frequency once more, I'll cry.
Cry?
I was just trying to start a conversation.
Mr. Spock looks different than in the cage.
Well, since it is illogical for a communications officer to resent the word frequency, I have no answer.
No, you have an answer. I'm an illogical woman who's beginning to feel too much a part of that communications
council. So he is Vulcanian.
Why don't you tell
me? Which is obviously different by the ears.
Or ask me if I've ever been in love. Tell me how your planet looks on a lazy evening when the moon is full.
In the cage.
Vulcan has no moon, Miss Uhura.
I'm not surprised, Mr.
But what
Spock.
I picked up in the cage is that Vulcans are quite a bit different than humans. But I think he's half human, too.
Bridge,
I think they said that in there.
I don't believe it.
Explain?
You explain. That means that somebody is dead and you just sit there. It could be Captain Kirk. He's the closest thing you have to a friend.
Lieutenant, my demonstration of concern will not change what has happened. The transporter room is very well manned, and they will call me if they need my assistance.
So the Vulcanians are much more serious type.
She called it a Borgia plant.
Smarter people, I think.
Bridge to dispensary.
Go ahead, Mr. Spock.
Borgia plant listed in library record tape says carbon group 3 vegetation, similar to Earth nightshade family. Alkaloid poison. Chemical structure common to most class M.
I'm curious. Alkaloid poison.
Strange mottling on his facial skin surface. There is no reference to this symptom.
But I'm curious to see how
this man wasn't
the computers are like in this day and age.
Stand by, Mrs. Spark. She says she saw him eat the plant.
But see, here he's got a big...
I know alkaloid poison, what to look for. There's not a trace of it in his body.
Look at that big bits of the plant computer monitor.
Jim, don't tell me my business. He could not have swallowed any. My instruments would have picked up any trace of it whatsoever.
Then what kills a healthy man?
I'll tell you something else. This man shouldn't be dead. I can't find anything wrong with him. According to all the tests, he should get up and just walk away from here.
So in this day and age, they're way above where we are now. But yet they still got these big square...
I don't know.
Giant
I'll have the
computer
test
monitors.
Check. My eyes may be tricking me. But I swear, Jim, when I first saw her, she looked just as I'd known her 10 years ago. Granted, the moment I may have been looking at her through a romantic haze.
How your lost love affects your vision, Doctor, doesn't interest me. I've lost a man. I want to know what killed him.
Well, he's...
Yes, sir.
A very serious captain. As you...
Captain's log, stardate 1513.4.
I like
in
this
orbit around planet
M113. He's constantly
crewman,
reporting dead.
Member of the landing party. Dead by violence. Cause unknown. But we are certain the cause of death was not poison.
Message, Captain. Starship base on Karan 4 requesting explanation of our delay here, sir. Space Commander Dominguez says we have supplies he urgently needs.
Tell Jose he'll get us chili peppers when we get there. Tell him they're prime Mexican reds. I handpicked them myself, but he won't die if he goes a few more days without them. Got it?
Got it, Captain.
Well?
No mistaking our record tapes. Borgia plant, sole deadly property is alkaloid poison.
And Professor Crater and wife?
Check out perfectly. They arrived here nearly 5 years ago, visited by various vessels, made fairly heavy shipments out of artifacts and reports. However, there has been a marked drop in shipments during the last year.
Dispensary to Captain.
Kirk here.
We found something.
What is it?
I'd rather not put it on the speaker.
Oh, boy, I wish I had doors that would just automatically open up like that.
So improbable, we almost didn't check it.
What?
Sodium chloride. Not a trace of it.
This man has no salt in his body
at all. Can you explain that, Doctor?
I can't.
I like the medical...
Except what we normally carry in our bodies.
Screen there that...
Yes.
You would die almost... To see there the chills.
There's a mark on his body.
Except the red rings on his face.
Various things. I'm not sure what they are now.
I thought it was.
Hopefully we'll see more of that.
Another error on my part.
I'm not counting them bones. Are you in the mood for an apology?
Forget it. I probably was mooning over. I should have been thinking about my job.
Perhaps you were. Both Nancy and Crater went out of their way to mention one item they needed.
Salt.
Mr. Spock.
Standing by.
Sturgeon, transport a sample of the plant to Mr. Spock. We'll check if it's actually the Borgia plant or something we don't understand. You got that, Mr. Spock?
Complete analysis.
Transporter would be cool.
Considering the inescapable fact that you are a trespasser on my planet...
Your complaint is noted, sir. Look. Something we don't understand killed one of my men. It could prove to be a danger to you and Mrs. Crater, too.
We've been here for almost 5 years. If there were anything hostile here, we would know about it, wouldn't we?
Bones, tell the professor what the autopsy revealed.
Our crewman died of salt depletion. A sudden total loss of it. Medically impossible by any standards.
And by coincidence, both you and Mrs. Crater requested salt tablets.
And your esteemed physician cannot explain our need for salt tablets?
We're all aware of the need for salt on a hot and arid planet like this, Professor. But it's a mystery. And I don't like mysteries. Give me a bellyache, and I got a beauty right now.
I started with 25 pounds. This is what we have left. Now, what is so mysterious about that?
Do you miss savory foods?
Mr. Spock.
Spock here.
Arrange quarters for Professor and Mrs. Crater. Did you get the plant analysis?
It is the Borgia variety, Captain. Could not have caused Darnell's death.
Jim, he's run off.
Oh, no, another
Nancy.
One has lipstick all over his face.
Yo! Salt! I've got salt! Smell it!
And
smell
it appears to be her.
Professor Crater!
Well, that was the second one, right? There's two victims now?
Professor Crater!
Yeah, that guy and then the other one that we could see more clearly. Is she somehow involved?
Sturgeon!
In this?
He's dead.
Oh, good coffee this morning.
Look, hey, crewman Green.
Green!
Green!
That's Green, apparently.
Crewman Green!
She is really looking very evil. And now, all of a sudden, she is Crewman Green.
Green! Green! Where are you?
So now...
Later he came this way. I don't know.
Things are starting to kind of come into the light.
Green!
Apparently she can change herself into...
Did you see this?
Yes, sir.
Crewman Sturgeon Green.
Was dead when I found him. I was circling to find whatever it was.
Same red rings on his face. Have you seen Nancy, Mrs. Crater?
No, sir. I checked all through the ruins.
I'm worried about her, Jim. She's not at the quarters. She's not at the diggings. She could be in trouble.
Nancy!
Crater!
Nancy, it's Leonard!
Beaming aboard the ship, Doctor.
You can't leave
We
her.
Can't search this whole planet on foot.
Jim!
You could learn something from Mr. Spock, Doctor. Stop thinking with your glands. We've equipment aboard the Enterprise that could pinpoint a match lit anywhere on this planet. Or the heat of a body. Transporter room. Kirk speaking. Three to beam up.
The Starship Enterprise. Now in the cage, we went over the top and we just kind of came down into the bridge, which is up on top. We haven't seen that yet here. I mean, that was a camera view as it came down.
Break out the surface
search
equipment.
Cool,
I want coordinates on two people.
It.
Acknowledged.
Put the body down and there, Sturgeon. We'll bring him home, sir. You could use some sleep, Bones.
All right, John.
Sleep? What is that? Well, here is Crewman Green, and here is a lovely young lady with a ton of hair. She looks like she has a basket on her.
What went on down there?
Oh, I ain't no spices, the salt.
Something odd, Captain. You said two people.
Professor and Nancy Crater.
We get a reading on only one person. Probably Crater. He's circling as if searching for something.
Expand search radius.
Yes, sir.
It's amazing that they can be way up while orbiting.
Why don't you go chase an asteroid?
Hey, Janice. Asteroid, is that for me?
Don't you wish it was?
I guess all the crewmen are
that.
Yeah, how'd you like to have her as your own personal
her.
Yeoman?
Captain's personal yeoman, he said. Life Sciences Botany Department. So what is her name? If anybody knows, please comment down below. Oh.
Where are you, Sulu?
In here feeding the weavers,
there
Dad.
There is a live
your tray.
Plant, I guess.
Of the galaxy. Bless your planet.
Hey, thank you. Hello, Beauregard. How are you
She called
today,
him.
Darling?
Her name's Gertrude.
No, it's a
Sulu.
Plant. A girl can tell.
Why do people have to call inanimate objects she? Like,
what kind of
she's
food
a
is
shit.
He is not an inanimate object. He's so animate, he makes me nervous. In fact, I keep expecting one of these plants
it
of
looks
yours
like
to
somebody's
me.
Got their hand up there. Didn't it? They looked like that to me. Here comes Green.
Hello, Green.
He's not talking today.
That has to be a wig that she's wearing. It's her hair would be 10 feet long.
You've been nipping Sari and Brandy or something?
Oh! Oh, you can definitely see the... Yeah, I could definitely see that that's somebody's under the table. That's interesting. That's kind of ingenious. by a plant.
Take it easy.
I'm assuming it's a plant.
Calm down. Very sensitive.
He's the real spook. Suppose he's going space happy or something?
Okay, here comes. I
forget her
name. The
door to my quarter still rattles when it opens. Would you stop by and see if you can do something?
She was on the bridge working.
Thanks, Bobby.
And now he just turned into somebody else. Trying to sleep.
Corridor bridge, Captain there.
Kirk here. Nothing to report, Doctor. We haven't located Mrs. Crater. What's the matter? Can't you sleep?
Nope.
Try taking one of those red pills you gave me last week. You'll sleep.
I'd like to have some of those red pills. I retired in 22, November. And I've been having so much trouble trying to adjust to, like, 9 to 5 hours. Because my job for years was graveyard shift before I retired. Now it just got still.
Unless there's something seriously wrong with the ship's equipment.
2:15 in the morning, and I've...
There's only one person within a 100-mile circle.
It's about 11 o'clock last night.
All right, we'll triangulate on him. We'll let Professor Crater explain what happened to his wife.
Because I just can't break that graveyard shift.
Keep a tight fix on us. If we let out a yell, I want an armed party down there before the echo dies.
Yes, Cap.
I really want doors like that in my house. So that's Mrs. Crater. I keep getting tangled up in my wire. Here I have Bluetooth things, but I don't know where they're at. Misplaced them.
Nancy. Well, come in, come in. I've been worried sick about you.
Wonder why Jim didn't tell me he found you.
I'm so happy to see you, Leonard. The others, I don't relate to them as much as with you. You have such strong memories of me.
So she has changed herself back.
You do care, don't you, Leonard? It makes me feel so safe.
Nancy.
My husband? I like your feelings better. Much stronger. But you're tired. You need to rest.
Who's the baddest, Jim? Kirk? He's been telling me to take these.
I think you should. I'll get you some.
Probably
more.
Not. Oh no.
Look at his face.
Oh, he's got the lip.
Brady Sulu. Trouble on deck 9, section 2. We need a medical team.
But apparently that's what happens. When all the salt's taken out of your body, because I know
Captain's
they mentioned
log,
that.
Stardate 15-13.8. I am now certain that the violent death of my crewman was caused by some strange life form.
Or so, Orin. Your husband.
And that appears to be the strange life form.
Crewman dying.
You're so Nancy tired, Crater. Darling. Just rest now.
Medical department alert. Doctors and medics, acknowledge.
It's nothing, dear. It's nothing. Just sleep. Nancy will take care of everything.
I want a closer look at everybody's personal quarters. Hopefully we'll get to see that.
Dr. McCoy, to the bridge. Dr. McCoy, to the bridge.
Looks like she might have given him quite a few of those pills. What's she gonna do now?
Dr. McCoy, to the bridge.
Oh, now there's no doubt about it. Nancy Crater is... I don't want to say an evil person, probably, but she's not what she appears to be. Because now she is...
Captain's log, addition.
Turned into Dr. McCoy.
Armed and able-bodied crewmen are not attacked and slaughtered this easily. Apparently, the killer can immobilize them as it approaches, perhaps with some hypnotic or paralyzing power. The answer lies with Professor Crater.
Professor Crater! Go away! We don't want you here!
We? Where's your wife, Professor? We're concerned about her.
I'm armed! Go away!
Where's your wife, Professor?
She's no concern of yours.
We're worried about her safety.
So they mentioned in the beginning
aren't
that
you?
This is an ancient
Professor, you're
civilization
a reasonable man.
That they were down here studying.
Kirk here.
Casualty captain. Like the Barnhart was Greek found dead on deck 9.
Same ruins same here. Oh.
Spock cutting in, Captain.
Something here through the arches to your left.
Stand by, Mr. Sulu.
Spock, is that green that they're find that they finally have found? Because they don't even know that she's green. On board.
He beamed up to the ship with us.
Or something.
Oh, okay, now they're going to figure it out. Well, these are good.
Enterprise,
I may have said that already.
Great, Sulu.
But
you have an intruder aboard. Could be masquerading as Crewman Green. General quarters. Security condition 3.
GQ, security 3, sir.
Have to forgive my...
General quarters 3.
Coughing
intruder
and
alert.
Throat clearing. I'm a former
three.
Smoker.
Intruder alert.
For some 40 years.
General quarters 3.
But I quit.
Intruder alert.
Back in 2007.
GQ
I have lingering.
Intruder alert.
Cough and
reporting
throat
GQ
problems.
Three secure, Captain. Do you
but I'm not ill from
there?
It.
Crater knows the creature. If we can take him alive.
Negative, Lieutenant. But keep locked in on us. Kirk out. Let's get him.
Wow, that was loud. I wasn't expecting that.
We don't want you here! We're happy alone! I've killed to stay alone! You hear that, Kirk? Or you'll have to kill me! I don't care either way!
GQ3, now secured except for decks 5, 7, and 10. Come in, please.
He's not in supply and maintenance. Sir.
All right, Uhura. Engineering deck now. Run through file photos of the crewman there.
Check.
Deck 5 reporting. Crewman Green is not in his quarters. No one has seen him.
Keep in mind if you find him, he's not Crewman Green. Captain reports Green's dead.
And he, or rather, it followed me. I thought there was something twitchy about him.
He... or whatever.
So these are going to be regular cast
members.
They must have been it. No, I would have remembered
Uhura.
A like him.
The creature leading your merry chase, Mr. Sulu.
Mr. Sulu.
Creature?
Or whatever it is that's killing the crewman.
Then I can't remember the other gal's
perhaps
name.
Perhaps I can help.
Baskethead. Wearing a basket on her head. That's what it looks like. She's awful attractive, that's for sure.
Set.
They look like my old flip phone. I used to have a flip phone.
Crater!
And the cage. Oh, they were see-through. Oh, that whole rock moved behind him. Oh, so much happened right there.
My wife, Professor, where is she?
Yeah, the flip phone communicators, I guess.
Your wife, Professor, where is she?
They were called in the cage, but we saw the rock
was
move
the
there.
Last of her kind.
And then the laser guns, the laser guns.
The last of
her
kind.
I don't know exactly what they're called. And I was
last
wondering if we
kind.
Would continue to see them in this... as a, you know, first season.
Earth history, remember? Like
and apparently we got.
Passenger pigeon or
But what are they called? Please comment down below if you know.
I feel strange.
Just done. You'll be able to think in a minute.
The Earth Buffalo. What about it?
Once there were millions of them. Prairies black with them. One herd covered three whole states. When they moved, like thunder.
And now they're gone. Is that what you mean?
I don't know if that's true or not. It probably was.
It's here. Once there were millions of them. Now there's one left. Nancy understood.
Always in the past tense.
Where's your wife? Where is she now?
Dead. Buried up on the hill that killed her.
When?
A year. Was it two?
So Nancy is dead.
Kirk to Enterprise.
Bridge to Captain. Sulu here.
It's definite, Mr. Sulu. The intruder can assume any shape. Crewman, you, myself, anyone. Do you understand?
Affirmative, Captain.
Go to GQ-4.
General Quarters 4, Captain.
The creature was trying to survive. It has that right, doesn't it?
Kirk to transporter room. 3 to beam up.
They needed salt to stay alive. There was no more salt. It's the...
So Nancy last is a creature.
The buffalo. There is no difference.
There's one, Professor.
And
your
Dr.
creature
McCoy
is killing my
don't
people.
Know that. If he even wakes up from... all the drugs that he took... I don't know how many took.
Captain's log,
things.
Continuing. The Enterprise has been invaded by a creature capable of assuming
I want to
any
learn
form
all about the Enterprise.
With the capacity to paralyze and draw the life
so
from any one of us.
Deck 5,
the bridge
three.
Is up
Deck
on
five,
top.
Section 3, report.
It's like
Security
that round
3A
dome
here.
Up there.
3B, in sight.
And apparently there's a round dome below. He's trying to
Negative,
wake up.
Captain. I've checked every face on this vessel. Was not a crewman I saw.
Young Ryan, how long was this green with you?
As long as it thought it could get to the salt in my tracer.
There it Spot. Is right there.
Supplies of salt have been set out as bait at all decks and engineering levels, Captain. However, no one or nothing has approached them as yet.
Dr. McCoy?
Yes?
Medical department report, Doctor.
Oh. Well, we could offer it salt without tricks. There's no reason for it to attack us.
Your attitude is laudable, Doctor, but your reasoning is reckless.
The creature is not dangerous when fed.
No, it's simply trying to survive by using its natural ability to take other forms.
The way the chameleon uses its protective coloring, an ability retained no doubt from its primitive state, the way we have retained our incisor teeth, they were once fangs. Certain of our muscles were designed for chase. It uses its ability the way we would use our muscles and teeth, if necessary, to stay alive.
And like us, it's an intelligent animal. There's no need to hunt it down.
A very interesting hypothesis, Doctor. Briefing room.
All the halls sealed off. All weapons accounted for and locked away. Security 4 in effect on every level. Still no lead on intruder.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
Yeah, that didn't sound like anything the doctor would say.
Crater, we don't know who or what we're looking for. We need your help, and now.
I demand it. I even beg that you get off my planet.
Can you recognize this thing when you see it?
Professor.
How funny, the creature is sitting right there with
I'll forgo charges up to this point. But this creature's aboard my ship, and I'll have it. Or I'll have your skin, or both. Now, where is it?
I loved Nancy very much. Few women like my Nancy. She lives in my dreams. She walks and sings in my dreams.
And it becomes Nancy for you?
Not because of tricks. It doesn't trick me. It needs love as much as it needs salt. When it killed Nancy, I almost destroyed it, but it isn't just a beast. It is intelligent. And the last of its kind.
I drink only one cup of coffee a day.
You're too pure and noble.
Are you saving the last of its kind, or has this become Crater's private heaven here on this planet? The
this thing becomes wife, lover, best friend, wise and man, fool,
water,
idle slave,
and or
isn't a bad life
sports
to
drinks, cause
have everyone in the universe at your beck and call. And you win all the arguments.
You don't understand.
Have you learned to see this thing in whatever form it becomes?
Yes.
Are you going to help us find it?
All right, coffee's done for the day.
Sorry, I can't.
Recommend we use truth serum, Captain.
Doctor.
Well, I resist using it, but in this case, the professor will give us the truth.
Thank you.
So that's like a three-way monitor there, apparently.
Oh, yes, of course.
But it's big and bulky, not like today. We would just have simple little flat screens, of course. As we do.
Captain Kirk to dispensary. Captain Kirk to dispensary.
I guess they couldn't really see that back then. But this would have been 64,
McCoy.
I do believe.
It was the creature. It hit me.
Pretty amazing.
The creature grabbed my phaser. Wondered about McCoy. Doubt it crossed my mind.
He's got a wound.
Captain.
On his head.
Professor Crater.
Dead.
Uh-oh.
It had you too.
Fortunately, my ancestors spawned in another ocean than yours did. My blood salts are quite different.
So here comes the creature back. And it's Nancy.
Leonard, wake up, please help me. Help me, Leonard. They're trying to kill me. Don't let them kill me.
I was wondering if he's going to wake up. I thought maybe she had given him an awful lot of those pills.
Move aside, Bones.
What's going on here, Jim?
She's not Nancy Bones.
What a thing to wake up to.
Are you insane?
It killed four crewmen. Now Crater.
It.
The creature. It kills. It needs salt to live. Bones, move aside.
No!
My guess is she needs more. You want it, Nancy?
So this creature just eats salt? Or needs salt to survive?
Come and get it.
Frightening her, Jim.
Excessive amounts of salt.
Hunger.
To boot.
Look at her.
I get dehydrated really
easy. Let me make him
now.
Go away.
Come on.
Older.
You want this, Nancy?
Be careful.
Come on, Nancy. Come and get it. Come and get it. Here it is. Bones, I can't find it. Get out of the way. Will you stop it?
Get out. McCoy, get out of the
What's
way.
What's the matter with you?
Hey, you want this?
Are you out of your mind?
Get out of the way.
Oh, she got grabbed the salt. Oh! Oh, is that how the red lipstick marks happen? Is she sucking the salt?
It's killing the captain. Shoot it, Dr. Quickly.
Tell him!
It's killing the captain. Shoot, quick!
I won't shoot Nancy.
Not Nancy!
Oh, wow.
She take this!
Stop it! Stop it, Spock! Stop it!
Is that Nancy, Doctor?
No.
Wow. That's a big quarters. You can see. Now, oh wow, that's what the creature truly looks like. Oh yeah, you see those suction cups? Oh no, you gotta do something, yes. Laser the creature. Needs a laser gun again, I guess.
Let it.
Oh, no.
Let it, no.
It's not her. It's not her.
Let it.
The Please. Captain's safe.
Or forgive me.
For now. Oh. Yeah, it was not her. It was the creature that likes salt.
I'm sorry, Bones.
Wow, that's a cool shot. Now you can see where the bridge is at. I want to so learn more about this show. Now that I'm retired and have all this time, I could start watching those things that I kind of missed.
Something wrong, Captain? I was thinking about the buffalo, Mr. Spock.
Doctor seems to be okay.
Warp one, Mr. Sulu.
Warp one, sir. Leaving warp.
Warp one. I know that the word warp means speed of light. I don't know how I know that. But I know that. So they are off on another adventure, and that's it. It's over. All right. All right, that was really, really good. I definitely enjoyed that. And I can take these out. Oh, I can hear again now. So that was really good. I enjoyed that. That was the first episode, apparently. And I look forward to seeing many more of them. So as I said, I'm going to try to do one episode a week, at least get one up a week. I don't know how hard it's going to be. I know how to edit. But this is going to be a different type of editing. It took me all day yesterday to get, the day before, to get the cage edited and put together. And then I upload it and it's blocked. It wasn't very, it made me feel pretty frustrated. So hopefully this will work out better, or I can figure out some other way to re-edit it and upload it and save, you know, more of it. So anyway, that's going to be it for now. I look forward to more Star Trek, the original series. And then after that, we'll move on to maybe, I know Star Trek went on and on and on for a lot of years after the original series. And then there's also movies with the original crew, this crew here, apparently. So we can get on to all those too. Eventually, but first we'll have to get through the first three seasons of the original series, and I'm looking forward to it. All right, so that's going to be it for now. Please like and subscribe and comment down below, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.